We can't live in a world in which you miss stories and we don't make every effort to fill you in on what's going on in the world of games geekdom. Well, that's why we're here. So here are the week's stories you may have missed. Number 5, Arnold Schwarzenegger revealed an important tidbit about the upcoming Terminator 6 film this week. Schwarzenegger spoke during an appearance in the UK about whether the 6th film will include the Genesis storyline in any way, and his answer was, it's going to ignore Genesis. Well, that's kind of a relief. He also added that Robert Patrick will not be back as the T-1000. Number 4, Atari has a new console coming out next year, but not much else was known about it except that it has a cool retro aesthetic. Well, now Atari revealed a lot more about the Atari Box. It will launch in late spring of next year, will be the full PC experience for the TV, and will bring apps, streaming, and much more. The console is affordable starting at $250 a pop and will support preloaded Atari games and current titles. Color me intrigued, Atari. Number 3, we have our final list of directors for Game of Thrones Season 8. So sad. Entertainment Weekly revealed Miguel Sapochnik is on deck to handle at least one episode from the upcoming season. The other director returning for the final season is none other than David Nutter, who previously directed Season 3's heart-wrenching The Reigns of Castamere. Two Emmy Award-winning directors to send off the known world in proper fashion. I dig it. Number 2, former Hellboy star Ron Perlman is sticking to his guns, or should I say his extremely large rock arm? When asked on Reddit during an AMA how he feels about the new movie reboot with David Harbour, Perlman simply replied, "I've made my peace with it. I refuse to answer any questions about it." Good on him. And number 1, The Last of Us 2 can't come soon enough, and thankfully Naughty Dog unveiled a new poster for the title to celebrate Outbreak Day that gave us a couple hidden secrets. The poster is a play on last year's Outbreak Day poster that featured Ellie's hand, and there's a clear juxtaposition. And then look closely a little bit, you'll see a wolf's head. What does it mean? Some speculate it hints at the location of the Pacific Northwest, possibly in Seattle, or could it mean that Joel will be a lone wolf in this sequel? We'll find out soon. So many questions. Those are the stories you may have missed this week. Be sure to watch our top 5 stories airing tomorrow, and check out our review of Cult of Chucky. Catch you later.